One question that has been plaguing SpaceX fans following spacecraft testing and development is when the Super Heavy booster, half of the company's next-generation spacecraft, will be launched. An updated document submitted by SpaceX to the U.S. Federal Communications Commission has revealed details about the company's plan for the first Starship booster, catch, attempt. The document follows a different batch submitted by SpaceX in June 2021. When the company detailed its plans for Starship's orbital launch debut as background, while requesting permission from the FCC to use Starlink dishes for in-flight telemetry. A month earlier, a different request focused on more standard telemetry antennas had already revealed that even if the mission went perfectly, Starship would not fully reach orbit on its first attempted spaceflight. It also confirmed that SpaceX had no intention of recovering the upper stage, or Super Heavy booster, assigned to Starship's launch debut. A sort of implicit acknowledgement that success was then not expected on the first try. 12 months later, SpaceX has submitted an updated overview of Starship's orbital launch debut, in a new request for permission to use multiple Starlink dishes, on both stages. While most of the document is the same, a few particular details have changed about Super Heavy's role in the mission. This time around, SpaceX says that the Super Heavy booster will separate, perform a partial return, and land in the Gulf of Mexico, or return to Starbase and be caught by the launch tower. Prior to this document, SpaceX's best-case plans for the first Super Heavy booster to launch never strayed from a controlled splashdown in the Gulf of Mexico, potentially demonstrating that it would be safe to attempt booster recovery on the next launch, but all but guaranteeing that the first booster would be lost at sea. A year later, SpaceX appears to be a bit more confident and wants to leave itself the option to attempt to recover the first Super Heavy booster that launches. However, the company has dramatically complicated the process of testing early Super Heavy and Starship recovery, and thus reuse by fully removing traditional and predictable landing legs and designing its latest prototypes, such that the only way they can be recovered in one piece is with a giant mechanized launch tower, nicknamed Mechazilla. The launch tower and its three mobile arms will play a crucial role in all aspects of orbital Starship launches. The first arm swings out to brace Super Heavy for Starship installation and connect the upper stage to power, propellant supplies, and other launch pad utilities. A more exotic pair of arms nicknamed chopsticks has a more complex job. On top of using the chopsticks to lift, stack, and demate Starships and Super Heavy boosters in almost any weather and wind conditions, SpaceX wants to use the arms as an incredibly complex and precarious rocket recovery system. For a booster or Starship catch, the rocket will approach the tower, enter the gap between the splayed arms, hover in place while the arms close around it, and eventually come to rest on hardpoints that appear to offer about as much surface area as a coffee table. Based on a simulation of the process shown by Elon Musk, calling it a catch is a misnomer, as the arms will mainly move in one dimension, open, close, and can't actually grab the rocket in any real sense. As built and shown, they are closer to a tiny fixed landing platform capable of minor last-second positional adjustments. Eventually, the chopsticks could shave a small amount of time off of post-recovery processing, removing the need for a crane or the same arms to attach to a landed booster or ship. They could also shave off the dry mass required for landing legs, though all interplanetary ships will still need legs. However, they will also inherently make proving their own efficacy a nightmare. By all appearances, the current recovery mechanisms on the arms and the landing hardpoints on ships and boosters mean that a catch could fail if either stage is more than a foot or two from a perfect bullseye or rotated a few degrees in the wrong direction. With the method SpaceX has devised, even the tiniest error could easily end with a massive, pressurized, partially fueled rocket destroying the chopsticks and plummeting a few hundred feet to the ground, guaranteeing an explosion that could damage surrounding infrastructure or start fires that might, in the event of larger anomalies during a landing attempt, Starship or Super Heavy could accidentally impact the launch tower, damaging or even outright destroying the skyscraper-sized structure. Ultimately, the immense risk posed by any catch attempt means that unless SpaceX has miraculously gotten the design of everything involved nearly perfect on its first try, the company will have to be extraordinarily cautious and expend a large number of ships and boosters to avoid rendering its only Starship launch tower unusable. At least to some extent, SpaceX likely knows this, and Super Heavy would likely need to be in excellent health and perform perfectly during the ascent and boostback portions of its launch debut to be cleared for a catch attempt. Ultimately, Starship's first orbital launch could end up being even more of a spectacle than it's already guaranteed to be. But even the company will say that it is difficult to make a reusable rocket. Musk's plan for the spacecraft is to make it fully reusable, allowing it to be used multiple times as an atypical spacecraft. Even if there are no plans to bring humans to Mars for permanent residence, reusing these dead spacecraft upon arrival would greatly reduce operating costs. The space rocket sector is one of the most expensive to buy. Musk has targeted a starting price of around $2 million, which could make space travel a commodity with roughly 100 passengers per trip. How great not to be so cool. To develop and test a spacecraft powerful enough to withstand the burden of a long journey to the Red Planet. SpaceX opted for a two-stage design that included very large boosters and an upper stage, known as the spacecraft, or simply two spacecraft, that would separate when the spacecraft left gravity. Super Heavy returns to the ground to prepare for the next shot in less than an hour, and Booster can land on retracted legs or use another crazy Musk idea, to get stuck in the air with both hands. It does not matter that this object, attached to the launch tower, will be the heaviest object ever attempted to be captured. The Super Heavy is a massive structure, about 70 meters high, with a distinctive silhouette at the SpaceX facility in Boca Chica, Texas. Testing is ongoing and it is also 9 feet wide. However, this is a step down from the original 12 meters that Musk gave us at the beginning of development. The booster's overall thrust can be achieved through a series of improvements that will be shown shortly in this video. Last month, the B-4 booster prototype was thought to be used on the first orbital flight with the S-20 ship, but now the awards for B-7 have been confirmed. This prototype wasn't the smoothest in development, but it ran just as smoothly as its predecessor, which had never been static fire tested. The team had to remove the booster from the launch pad for repairs after the failure of the first test. It is the first 33-engine launch vehicle and the first prototype spacecraft to use the new Raptor V2 engine in action. However, the Starship needed something more powerful. And SpaceX decided to build a new engine, naming it the Raptor with the design. SpaceX is introducing lots of insane concepts that few rocket companies have tried. The result is a beast masquerading as a rocket engine. Each Raptor engine weighs about 1.5 tons and will supply 230 tons of thrust-to-weight ratio to the Starship. The engine itself is evolving, with Raptor 2 now deep into testing at SpaceX's McGregor test site. Thanks for watching this video, and it's a super interesting topic. If you like this, make sure to subscribe. If you have any crazy ideas about what we should cover in next video, please comment it below, and we'll see if we can get to it. So thanks again for watching and goodbye.